today is Sanjana Chandran, who at 17 is already a very accomplished violinist. Sanjana, welcome.
Hello.
Thank you so much for being a part of this first performance.
Thank you for interviewing me.
Of course, yes. So for those who haven't had the pleasure of listening to you play before, would you mind sharing a little bit more about yourself, how you got interested in music, and especially why the violin?
I was always interested in music from a young age since my dad was a musician, and I'd always be surrounded by music. My dad being a violinist, I always felt that violin was meant to be for me. I would always listen to my dad teach other students until one day I picked up the violin, and my love for violin grew as I realized how versatile the instrument was and how well it mimicked the human voice.
Mm-hmm. Well, very interesting. So what kind of training have you gone through then? And you know, how many years have you been playing? I think you also had an Arangetram, is that right?
Yeah, I started learning violin at the age of 6 in Carnatic style of Indian classical music. And after a few years, I picked up and I started learning the Western classical style. And despite like the multitude of differences between the two styles, there were various techniques that I picked up on that I incorporated into my Indian classical playing. I also started exploring Hindustani Indian classical music recently. And by mixing the nuances of the three different styles, I would create new music and compositions.
Oh, that's wonderful. So you're creating some of your own music and playing around with all the different styles. So that's great. So what advice would you have for young folks who are interested in maybe not just the violin, but any type of music and any type of vocal or dance? Just what, you know, what they should do if they wanted to make it something more than a hobby and really, really hone in on those skills.
Yeah, I believe that the world currently needs creativity and solidarity more than ever to solve our present issues. And artists, like any type, are uniquely positioned to provide both. There is currently a lot of mental stress due to the economic, health, and social challenges we are currently facing. And with artists coming together at this time, we can provide an outlet for people to forget their stresses.
Yes, for sure. And I think doing this during this time, many of us are stuck at home. We might be worried about our loved ones possibly getting sick or getting COVID-19. And so this is definitely a wonderful way for people to enjoy music from the comfort of their living room and just sort of take a step back and enjoy the moment a little bit. So thank you for being a part of that. That's certainly, you know, to be able to put a smile on someone's face or just take them away from their stress is certainly something something wonderful, and we appreciate that. What do you hope in particular that everyone listening will take away from this performance?
Well, I hope that listeners can learn from this performance that social distancing doesn't have to prevent a person from spreading their message or their art form. Like through these technological platforms, one can use these resources effectively and communicate and spread their message.
Yes, definitely. We are very thankful in these times that we have all of this technology available to us. We certainly, you know, it wasn't always the case. And it's wonderful that we do have this now where we can still stay in touch and still enjoy music performances like this one. So thank you again. We really appreciate you being a part of this. Thank you for taking some time to speak with us today.
Thank you.